我们马上先来示范题的阶段。那示范题，我们先来试试看单选题。好，示范题，单选题，第一题，请出题。
Which of the following countries has the largest Muslim population? A. Saudi Arabia. B. Bangladesh. C. Turkey. D. Indonesia.
请作答。请公布答案。Sorry， 请出示答案。请公布答案。
The correct answer is D. Indonesia.
丽人高中答对，金城高中答对，复兴十中答对，慈济高中答对，明德高中答对，金门高中答对，港明高中答对，小明女中答对，正大附中答对。协同高中答对，德光高中答对，武林高中答对，南光高中答对，建国中学答对，崇光女中答对，维格高中答对，西明高中答对。示范题，单选题，第二题，请出题。
Number two, when traveling internationally, your passport should have a validity of at least how long a period? A. 3 months. B. 6 months. C. 1 year. D. 45 days. One more time. When traveling internationally, your passport should have a validity of at least how long a period? A. 3 months. B.6 months. C. 1 year. D. 45 days.
请作答。作答时间到，请出示答案。请公布答案。
The correct answer is B. 6 months.
丽人高中答对，金城高中答对，复兴十中答对，慈济高中答对，明德高中答对，金门高中答对，港明高中答对，小明女中答对，正大附中答对。协同高中答对，德光高中答对，武林高中答对，南光高中答对，建国中学答对，崇光女中答对，维格高中答对，西明高中答对。好的，那接下来呢，我们要来练习的是复选题的部分了。那复选题的部分呢，我们这边美丽的科员他会帮我们一同在公布答案的时候，也把两个选项，两个正确的选项也会在那边帮我们做正确或者是错误的认证。好，所以同学们，我们要进入的是复选题咯。示范题，复选题，第一题，请出题。
Which of the following countries are members of European Union? A. Germany. B. France. C. Switzerland. D. Norway. One more time. Which of the following countries are members of European Union? A. Germany. B. France. C. Switzerland. D. Norway.
请作答。作答时间到，请出示答案。请公布答案。
The correct answer is A, Germany, and B, France.
丽人高中答错，金城高中答对，复兴十中答对。好，所以啊，我们来顺一下，是说我的正确跟错误要看您手上的圈跟叉，是不是？好，那我就不看我这边的东西，我完全看您喽，可以吗？因为我可能没有办法有这么，对，我直接看您，然后报答案。OK， 好，那我就继续从刚刚从我想一下，从好从慈济高中好了，哎，复兴十中刚刚讲过的对不对 ？OK， 那从慈济高中，好，慈济高中答对，明德高中答对，金门高中答对，港明高中答对。小明女中答对，政大附中答对，协同高中答对，德光高中答对，武林高中答对，南光高中答对，建国中学答对，崇光女中答对，维格高中答对，新民国中答对。好，那我们继续复选题的部分，示范题第二题，请出题。
Which of the following countries are diplomatic allies of the Republic of China or Taiwan? A. Saint Lucia. B. The Republic of Chad. C. Burkina Faso. D. Eswatini. One more time.Which of the following countries are diplomatic allies of the Republic of China or Taiwan? A. Saint Lucia. B. The Republic of Chad. C. Burkina Faso. D. Eswatini.
请作答。作答时间到，请出示答案。请公布答案。
The correct answers are A. Saint Lucia and D. Eswatini.
丽人高中答对，金城高中答对，复兴十中答对，慈济高中答对，明德高中答对，金门高中答对。港明高中答对，小明女中答对，政大附中答对，协同高中答对，德光高中答对，武林高中答对，南光高中答对，建国中学答对，崇光女中答对，维格高中答对，新民高中答对。好，所以我们示范题的部分这样子，大家有没有什么问题？有没有什么要调整的，或是有音量？来，请说。音量大声一点，是不是？我们请口译老师念题目，可能麻烦帮我们再大声一点点，谢谢。
OK。 Try it again.
好的，那我们请出题的口译老师可以再帮我们念刚刚的任何一个题目，让同学们测试一下听得清不清楚好吗？谢谢您。
Okay, which of the following countries has the largest Muslim population?
有比较好吗 ？OK 吗？好啊，那我们要正式开始喽。好，那我前面的规则要再讲一次，对不对？好的。OK。好的，所有的队伍都已经就定位了，接下来要进行的就是益智问答。为各位介绍比赛规则，本阶段的益智问答比赛各队需全员参加，比赛全程以英文进行提问，参赛队伍现场会聆听司仪念完两遍题目之后，我这边会宣布请作答，请再开始作答。题目有单选题十题，请选出唯一正确的答案代号。复选题会有五题，每题有两个正确的选项。回答完全正确能得十分。答题的时候，不论是写错、多写或是少写选项，皆不得分。每题会有15秒的作答时间，会采倒数计时，所以听到铃响的时候就要停止作答，并且出示答案板。那益智问答的分数会占总分的15%。我们有请到的是外交部公众外交协调会吴宣如兼任科员，为我们担任今天益智问答的评审。好的，那接下来就正式进入益智问答的环节了。首先是单选题，单选题第一题，请出题。
Which of the following international organizations is Taiwan an official member of? A. The United Nations. B. The International Criminal Police Organization, or Interpol. C. The International Civil Aviation Organization, or ICAO. D. The World Vegetable Center. One more time. Which of the following international organizations is Taiwan an official member of?A. The United Nations. B. The International Criminal Police Organization, or Interpol. C. The International Civil Aviation Organization, or ICAO. D. The World Vegetable Center.
请作答。作答时间到，请出示答案。
The correct answer is D, the World Vegetable Center.
立仁高中答错，金城高中答对，复兴十中答对，慈济高中答对，明德高中答对，金门高中答对。港明高中答对，小明女中答对，政大附中答对，协同高中答错，德光高中答对，武林高中答对，南光高中答对，建国中学答对，崇光女中答对，维格高中答对，新民高中答错。紧接着进行单 单选题第二题，请出题。
In March 2018, U.S. President Donald Trump signed which of the following bills into law to promote high-level official visits between Taiwan and the U.S.? A. The Taiwan Relations Act. B. The Taiwan-U.S. Relations Act. C. The Taiwan Travel Act. D. The National Defense Authorization Act. One more time. In March 2018,U.S. President Donald Trump signed which of the following bills into law to promote high-level official visits between Taiwan and the U.S.? A. The Taiwan Relations Act. B. The Taiwan-U.S. Relations Act. C. The Taiwan Travel Act. D. The National Defense Authorization Act.
请作答。作答时间到，请出示答案。请公布答案。
The correct answer is C, the Taiwan Travel Act.
丽人高中答对，金城高中答对，复兴十中答对，慈济高中答对，明德高中答对，金门高中答对，港明高中。答错，小明女中答对，正大附中答对，协同高中答对，德光高中答对，武林高中答对，南光高中答对，建国中学答对，崇光女中答错，维格高中答对，西民高中答对。紧接着进行单选题第三题，请出题。
The 2020 Summer Olympics will be held in which of the following cities? A. Tokyo B. Seoul C. Sydney D. Auckland One more time. The 2020 Summer Olympics will be held in which of the following cities? A. Tokyo B. Seoul C. Sydney D. Auckland
请作答。作答时间到，请出示答案。请公布答案。
The correct answer is A, Tokyo.
丽人高中答对，金城高中答对，复兴十中答对，慈济高中答对，明德高中答对，金门高中答对，港明高中答对，小明女中答对，正大附中答对，协同高中。答对，德光高中答对，武林高中答对，南光高中答对，建国中学答对，崇光女中答对，维格高中答对，西民高中答对。紧接着进行单选题第四题，请出题。
Which of the following statements is correct? A. The Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, or RCEP, is a free trade agreement led by the United States. B. Taiwan joined RCEP in 2018. C. The General Secretariat of the Association of Southeast Asian Nations, or ASEAN, is located in Jakarta. D.India is one of the founding countries of ASEAN. One more time. Which of the following statements is correct? A. The Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, or RCEP, is a free trade agreement led by the United States. B. B. Taiwan joined RCEP in 2018. C. The General Secretariat of the Association of Southeast Asian Nations, or ASEAN, is located in Jakarta. D. India is one of the founding countries of ASEAN.
请作答。作答时间到，请出示答案。请公布答案。
The correct answer is C, the General Secretariat of the Association of Southeast Asian Nations, or ASEAN, is located in Jakarta.
立仁高中答对。金城高中答对。复兴十中答对。慈济高中答对。明德高中答对，金门高中答对，港明高中答对，小明女中答对，政大附中答对，协同高中答对，德光高中答对，武林高中答对，南光高中答对。建国中学答对，崇光女中答对，维格高中答对，新民高中答对。紧接着进行单选题第五题，请出题。
On June 12th of this year, U.S. President Donald Trump and North Korean leader Kim Jong-un met for the first time in which of the following countries? A. Canada. B. South Korea. C. Singapore. D. Switzerland. One more time. On June 12th of this year, U.S. President Donald Trump and North Korean leader Kim Jong-un met for the first time in which of the following countries?A. Canada. B. South Korea. C. Singapore. D. Switzerland.
请作答。作答时间到，请出示答案。请公布答案。
The correct answer is C, Singapore.
立仁高中答对。金城高中答对。复兴十中答对。慈济高中答对。明德高中答对。金门高中答对。港明高中答对。小明女中答对。政大附中答对，协同高中答对，德光高中答对，武林高中答对，南光高中答对，建国中学答对，崇光女中答对，维格高中答对，新民高中答对。接着进行单选题第六题，请出题。
The 2018 G20 Summit is being held in which of the following countries? A. Japan. B. Australia. C. Germany. D. Argentina. One more time. The 2018 G20 Summit is being held in which of the following countries? A. Japan.B. Australia. C. Germany. D. Argentina.
请作答。 作答时间到，请出示答案。请公布答案。
The correct answer is D, Argentina.
立人高中答错。金城高中答对。复兴十中答对。慈济高中答对。明德高中答对。金门高中答错。港明高中答对。小明女中答对。正大附中答对，协同高中答对，德光高中答对，武林高中答对，南光高中答对，建国中学答对，崇光女中答对，维格高中答对，新民高中答对。接着进行单选题第七题，请出题。
Which of the following services do Taiwan's overseas missions provide to citizens abroad? A. Providing daily weather and travel information. B. Helping to bargain over restaurant prices. C. Processing new passports in case of lost or theft. D. Paying for lodging and transportation.One more time. Which of the following services do Taiwan's overseas missions provide to citizens abroad? A. Providing daily weather and travel information. B. Helping to bargain over restaurant prices. C. Processing new passports in case of lost or theft. D. Paying for lodging and transportation.
请作答。作答时间到，请出示答案。请公布答案。
The correct answer is C, processing new passports in case of lost or theft.
立人高中答错。金城高中答错。复兴十中答对。慈济高中答对。明德高中答错。金门高中答对，港明高中答对，小明女中答对，正大附中答对，协同高中答对，德光高中答对，武林高中答对，南光高中答对，建国中学答对，崇光女中答错。维格高中答对，新民高中答对。接着进行单选题第八题，请出题。
This year, Taiwan was represented by TSMC founder Morris Zhang at the Asia-Pacific Economic Cooperation Summit, or APEC. In which of the following countries was this year's summit held? A. Singapore. B.Papua New Guinea, C, Chile, D, Vietnam. One more time. This year, Taiwan was represented by TSMC founder Morris Zhang at the Asia-Pacific Economic Cooperation Summit, or APEC. In which of the following countries was this year's summit held? A, Singapore, B, Papua New Guinea, C, Chile, D, Vietnam.
请作答。作答时间到，请出示答案。请公布答案。
The correct answer is B, Papua New Guinea.
立人高中答错，金城高中答对，复兴十中答对，慈济高中答对， 明德高中，答对。金门高中，答对。港民高中，答对。小明女中，答对。政大附中，答对。协同高中，答对。德光高中，答对。武林高中，答对。南光高中，答对。建国中学，答对。崇光女中，答对。维格高中，答对。新民高中，答对。紧接着进行单选题第九题，请出题。
Which of the following is not covered under the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals? A. Reducing inequality domestically and across the world. B. Strengthening aerospace research. C. Eliminating hunger and achieving food security. D. Taking emergency measures to address climate change and its effects. One more time.Which of the following is not covered under the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals? A. Reducing inequality domestically and across the world. B. Strengthening aerospace research. C. Eliminating hunger and achieving food security. D. Taking emergency measures to address climate change and its effects.
请作答。作答时间到，请出示答案。请公布答案。
The correct answer is B, strengthening aerospace research.
丽人高中答对。金城高中答对。复兴十中答对。慈济高中答对。明德高中答对。金门高中答对。港民高中答对，小明女中答对，政大附中答对，协同高中答对，德光高中答对，武林高中答对，南光高中答对，建国中学答对，崇光女中答对，维格高中答对，新民高中答对。接着进行单选题第十题，请出题。
Which of the following practices does not comply with international etiquette? A. When two women meet, either the older or married one shall first extend her hand in greeting. B. Hosts shall first extend their hand in greeting their guests. C. When meeting a woman for the first time, a man generally does not shake hands with her.D. When meeting a superior or elderly, you may first extend your hand in greeting. One more time. Which of the following practices does not comply with international etiquette? A. When two women meet, either the older or married one shall first extend her hand in greeting. B. Hosts shall first extend their hand in greeting their guests. C.When meeting a woman for the first time, a man generally does not shake hands with her. D. When meeting a superior or an elderly, you may first extend your hand in greeting.
请作答。作答时间到，请出示答案。请公布答案。
The correct answer is D. When meeting a superior or an elderly, you may first extend your hand in greeting.
丽人高中答错。金城高中答错。复兴十中答对。慈济高中答对。明德高中答错。 金门高中答错。港明高中答对。小明女中答错。正大附中答对。协同高中答对。德光高中答对。武林高中答对。南光高中答错。建国中学答对。崇光女中答对。维格高中答对。新民高中答对。接下来要进行的是复选题了，我们再重申一次，每题会有两个正确的选项，回答完全正确能得十分。那不管是写错、多写或是少写选项，皆不得分。现在进行复选题，第一题，请出题。
Which of the following countries are participating in talks for both the Comprehensive and Progressive Agreement for Trans-Pacific Partnership, or CPTPP, and the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, or RCEP? A. Japan. B. India. C. Vietnam. D. The Philippines. One more time. Which of the following countriesare participating in talks for both the Comprehensive and Progressive Agreement for Trans-Pacific Partnership, or CPTPP, and the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership, or RCEP? A. Japan. B. India. C. Vietnam. D. The Philippines.
请作答。作答时间到，请出示答案。请公布答案。
The correct answers are A. Japan and C. Vietnam.
丽人高中答错。金城高中答对。复兴十中答错。慈济高中答对。明德高中答对。金门高中答错。港明高中答对。小明女中答对。正大附中答对。协同高中答对。德光高中答对。武林高中答对。南光高中答错。建国中学答对。崇光女中答错。维格高中答对。新民高中答错。紧接着进行复选题第二题。请出题。
Taiwanese youth can go to which of the following countries for working holidays? A. The Netherlands. B. Spain. C. The Czech Republic. D. Belgium. One more time. Taiwanese youth can go to which of the following countries for working holidays? A. The Netherlands. B. Spain. C.The Czech Republic. D. Belgium.
请作答。作答时间到，请出示答案。请公布答案。
The correct answers are C, the Czech Republic, and D, Belgium.
丽人高中答对。金城高中答对。复兴十中答对。慈济高中 答对。明德高中答错。金门高中答错。港明高中答对。小明女中答对。正大附中答对。协同高中答对。德光高中答对。武林高中答对。南光高中答对。建国中学答对。崇光女中答对。维格高中答对。新民高中答对。接着进行复选题第三题，请出题。
In recent years, Taiwan has participated in bilateral, multilateral, and plurilateral trade negotiations with other nations across the world. With which of the following countries has Taiwan signed bilateral economic cooperation agreements? A. New Zealand. B. Australia. C. Cambodia. D. Singapore. One more time. In recent years,Taiwan has participated in bilateral, multilateral, and plurilateral trade negotiations with other nations across the world. With which of the following countries has Taiwan signed bilateral economic cooperation agreements? A. New Zealand. B. Australia. C. Cambodia. D. Singapore.
请作答。作答时间到，请出示答案。请公布答案。
The correct answers are A. New Zealand and D. Singapore.
丽人高中答错。金城高中答对。复兴十中答对。慈济高中答对。明德高中答错。金门高中答错，港明高中答对，小明女中答对，正大附中答对，协同高中答对，德光高中答对，武林高中答对，南光高中答错，建国中学答对。崇光女中答对，维格高中答对，新民高中答对。接着进行复选题第四题，请出题。
Which of the following countries are members of the Quadrilateral Security Dialogue or Quad Talks, which is now part of the U.S. Indo-Pacific Strategy?A. South Korea. B. India. C. Cambodia. D. Japan. One more time. Which of the following countries are members of the Quadrilateral Security Talk or Quad Talks, which is now part of the U.S. Indo-Pacific Strategy? A. South Korea. B. India. C. Cambodia. D. Japan.
请作答。作答时间到，请出示答案。请公布答案。
The correct answers are B. India and D. Japan.
丽人高中答错，金城高中答错，复兴十中答错，慈济高中答错，明德高中答错， 金门高中答错。港明高中答错。港明高中答错。小明女中答错。正大附中答错。协同高中答错。德光高中答对。武林高中答错。南光高中答错。建国中学答对。崇光女中答错。维格高中答错。新民高中答错。接着进行复选题第五题，请出题。
Which of the following describe the core spirit of steadfast diplomacy? A. Contributing to international society. B. Mutual assistance for mutual benefit. C. Unilateral aid for our allies. D. Spending large sums to establish diplomatic relations with other countries. One more time. Which of the following describe the core spirit of steadfast diplomacy?A. Contributing to international society. B. Mutual assistance for mutual benefit. C. Unilateral aid for our allies. D. Spending large sums to establish diplomatic relations with other countries.
请作答。作答时间到，请出示答案。请公布答案。
The correct answers are A. Contributing to international society and B. Mutual assistance for mutual benefit.
丽人高中答对。京城高中答对。复兴十中答错。慈济高中答错，明德高中答对，金门高中答对，港明高中答对，小明女中答错，正大附中答对，协同高中答对，德光高中答错，武林高中答对。南光高中答错，建国中学答对，崇光女中答错，维格高中答对，新民高中答错。好的，我们第三阶段的比赛到此结束了，大家辛苦了。三个阶段各项的比赛成绩乘以所占的百分比加总后的总分，就是今天的总成绩了。经过了非常漫长的初赛，一直到今天的总决赛，同学们都付出了非常非常多的心力。现在我们又要来，对不起，对，就要来，对。从初赛一直到今天的总决赛，漫漫长路，同学们终于要来揭晓我们的成绩了，大家紧不紧张？好，稍微缓和一下哦。在正式公布成绩之前呢，我们要特别邀请到的是教育部国民级学前教育署的陈东莹科长上台来跟同学们勉励一下，掌声欢迎。
谢谢主持人，也谢谢今天我们公视给我们举办这么好的活动哈。那107年度呢，外交小尖兵英语种子队的选拔活动呢，那在经过一整天的比赛之下呢，那各位同学的表现都非常的杰出，那非常的努力，那在此呢，给同学呢给自己一个掌声鼓励。 那也谢谢我们美丽主持人帮我们主持这一整天的活动，谢谢。
谢谢帅哥科长。
啊，是，谢谢。那接下来呢，我们就揭晓今天的哈，应该是我们的。
是的，接下来我们要有请科长为我们来揭晓的呢，是我们在决赛获得表现优等奖的五个队伍，所以我们会唱名五个队伍一起上来，那都可以获得奖金10000块哦。所以有请陈科长为我们公布这五支队伍。
好，谢谢主持人哈。那以下呢，这五个这个优等的队伍呢是不计名次哈。那我们以这个序号来排列哈，首先是序号三。台北市复兴实验高级中学，接下来序号四，台南市慈济高级中学，接下来是序号七，台南市港民高级中学，接下来是序号八，台中市小明女子高级中学。接下来是序号十四，台北市建国高级中学。
好的，我们有请陈科长帮我们颁奖。首先，第一排的同学来，我们先往前一小步。好，有请科长帮我们颁奖，并且跟他们合照一张。来，一起看我们前面的这个摄影师。好，谢谢。来，第一排的同学请入座，恭喜你们。接下来，来，请往前。好，看前面的这个摄影大哥哦，拿着单眼相机的这一位。好，恭喜你们。来，我们可以回座休息。来，接下来恭喜你们。好的，谢谢，辛苦你们了。来，同学这边请。好，接下来，好的，来，同学这边请。好，恭喜以上队伍获得优等奖10000元，也谢谢，非常谢谢陈科长，谢谢您。好的，我们刚刚呢颁的是不计名次我们的优等奖的队伍了。那接下来呢，我们继续邀请到的是外交部夏纪昌总领事回部办事，要上台跟同学们勉励一下，掌声有请，欢迎夏总领事。
我们在座所有的同学们、老师们、家长们，还有我们公共电视的工作伙伴，还有美丽的主持人，大家好。
好，
非常高兴哦，今天又能够参加我们外交小尖兵的种子队，这个英语种子队的选拔哦。这个活动啊，已经17年了。其实17年前我就参加过，但是当时我是这个承办人之一哦。那我看到这17年来，我们这么多的我们的年轻的朋友们哦，参与这个活动，非常非常的感动哦。那今天在座的所有的同学们啊，你们都经过激烈的初赛，然后能够进入决赛，其实能够进入决赛，代表你们的才识，还有你们的英语表达能力都非常非常的好。更重要的是，你们有勇于挑战自己的勇气。那我希望今天不管结果怎么样，我希望大家都能够记得今天的比赛的这个整个过程，会成为你们人生中一个最值得回忆的一页。那当然，这个活动我还是要感谢我们所有参与的我们公共电视的团队，还有各个高中，尤其是我们在桃园的武林高中，还有台中的新民高中跟高雄的左营高中，那他们帮我们办了初赛，那还有各个学校的老师，其实他们投入非常多，能够让这活动能够延续17年。那我们也希望我们外交部能够再继续跟外交跟教育部合作，然后让这个计划能够持续进行。因为我们外交部还有我们教育部一直希望能够培养我们年轻的同学们能够参与国际事务，也希望所有的外交小尖兵在今天的结束比赛之后呢，你们能够成为我们真正的外交尖兵。
好，谢谢夏东领事。夏东领事其实今天算是回这个外交小尖兵像一个娘家的感觉，对不对？所以呢，能够从夏总领事手上拿到这份荣耀的同学们，一定要将这份荣誉心永存于心，并且将我们所有的精神继续的发扬光大。
是的。
好，那现在呢，紧张的时刻就要有请夏总领事帮我们先来宣布两支得奖的特优队伍，那可以获得奖杯还有奖金25,000元。那也请得奖的队伍同学们要记得赶快上台来领奖哦。好，我们有请夏总领事帮我们公布两支特优队伍。
好，我先宣布第五名。
是。
第五名是序号16号台北市私立维格高级中学。
恭喜维格高中，来我们这边请。
然后名次第四名的是序号9号国立政治大学附属高级中学。
啊，政大附
中的。好，恭喜两个学校的同学们。
来，好的，那我们也有请呢夏总领事帮我们颁奖。那我们小心您的脚步哦，我们政大附中的同学在比较后面一点点。好，来，我们排在后面这边。好的。那我们请前排的队伍同学先往前一点，跟我们的夏东领事一起合照，并且接受颁奖，恭喜你们，给他们一个热烈的掌声。好，谢谢你们，来我们这边请，接下来政大附中同学请往前。好，我们有请夏东领事继续帮我们颁奖，恭喜你们获得特优。哦，还有个奖杯哦，来，请我们请夏总领事帮我们颁奖杯给我们同学。好 ，OK， 好，谢谢你们，谢谢。
太棒了。
好 ，OK， 接下来就是我们非常紧张、刺激要公布前三名了。那这个前三名的队伍呢，除了有奖杯还有奖金之外，最荣誉的就是可以由外交部安排你们到国外去参访，帮我们做好国民外交，这是一个非常重大的荣誉跟使命哦。所以接下来我们就要请夏总领事帮我们公布第三名。
好，第三名是序号2号彰化县私立金城高级中学。
恭喜金城高中，来，
恭喜金城高中
第三名，金城高中的同学来到我们舞台中央，接受夏总领事的颁奖。我们有奖杯、奖金，更重要的是，你们是外交小尖兵，要代表台湾参访。要做好国民外交哦！来看前方的摄影师，恭喜你们！哦，摄影大哥要帮你们拍下最美的画面。这个呢，除了是珍贵的纪念，也是一个证据啊！你们一定要好好的做好国民外交，带着这份精神，谢谢你们！好，请回座，恭喜恭喜！好的，接下来我们有请夏总领事帮我们公布第二名。
第二名是序号11号台南市德光高级中学。
恭喜德光高中，来，请同学们到台中央接受夏总领事的颁奖，非常不容易。除了有奖杯、奖金之外，外交小尖兵的使命就交到你们身上了。恭喜你们获得107年度外交小尖兵的第二名亚军，恭喜你们！好，谢谢谢谢，来，同学，我们这边请，也希望你们呢能够收获满满。好哇，藏不住的笑意。 好的 ，Ladies and Gentlemen， 接下来我们就要正式为各位公布107年外交小尖兵的冠军第一名。
第一名是。Winner goes to 序号十二号桃园市立武林高级中学。
恭喜武林高中！哇，武林高中的同学们，恭喜你们获得107年外交小尖兵的第一名。除了有奖杯、奖金之外，这一次外交小尖兵我们出国采访的使命就在你们身上了，请继续带着这一股热情跟冲劲，将我们台湾的美好还有我们的精神推广到国际，让更多的朋友感受到。谢谢你们，谢谢，恭喜第一名，谢谢。是的，我们也非常谢谢夏总领事帮我们颁奖，谢谢您，谢谢。